Hello everyone, I welcome you all to yet another episode of Thoughtful Leadership series on collegedunia.com. Today we have the principal from Pillu Modi College of Architecture, and this college, I tell you, this is 35 years old college, which is situated in Cuttack in Odisha. And here we have the principal of PMCA, and we'll have a short discussion with her, and she'll obviously tell you about the insights of how the college has been working since these years, and she will obviously share her insights on the point of view and opinions about today's education industry. I welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes,
I'll just have to add that this college started in 1993, actually, so it is 28 years old.
Okay, so ma'am, actually on the internet, it has started from 1985, whatever I have seen.
That was a trust. That is when the trust started.
Okay. No issues, ma'am. It's been 28 years, so it's a very pretty long year. I guess this is the first college that we have of architecture in Odisha.
It's not the first, but the first private college.
Okay.
The first private college in Odisha. The government college in Bhubaneswar, that is the oldest.
Yes. Definitely, we'll get to know about all the things as we proceed further with the interview and when you share all the insights, as I said, so that the students, the viewers who are watching us, watching you, they'll get a lot of idea about how exactly Pillu Modi College is working and what it offers for their higher education ahead. So we'll proceed with the questions, ma'am. So ma'am, since you have, I guess you have been associated with this college in the long period of time right now. So, and you might have also held key positions in the college, in the education institutes throughout your career. So I just wanted to know that what are the key factors that keep you connected with the education industry?
Key factors, I would say, just that we try to develop this alliance between the construction industry and education. And so, like, you know, even being an architect or as a professional also, all professional architects also try and, maintain this thing. They would come here and take certain guest lectures or classes and, you know, so, you know, it's like kind of giving back to the society sort of thing. So, like, you know, you feel at the end of the day, the whatever development in the construction industry has to be passed down to the education field. So that's because we are actually educating and making the architects. We are the architects of architects. That's how, like, you know, we take it like that. The architects who would go out and, you know, build the country, you know, we, as a college, as an educational institute, we are actually responsible for, you know, building them, I would say. So I'd say that we are the architects of the architects.
Okay, so you are saying that since you build all the architects, that is actually the key factor, which is being, because yes, obviously you are connected. And if you're teaching all the architects, being an architect, that makes the bond, and you have been associated with this industry because of this bond, right? So yes, ma'am. So moving towards the next question, being the principal of PMCA College, what is the philosophy of your leadership, whatever you have done till date in PMCA? So obviously you are in a higher position, you are a leader of that college. So I just wanted to know that how would you describe your leadership style?
Okay, I believe in complete transparency. So there is academic transparency, integrity and accountability from all sections. That is what we aim at. Then we are always focused on quality. So we try to deliver to the best of our abilities, and we also ensure that there is, you know, honesty and integrity in the teaching, in the learning, teaching-learning process. And that's how I would say, like, you know, that is our basically the values or the value system that we have tried to adopt in the college. I have tried to adopt, I would say.
Okay, so ma'am, the next question is definitely, you know, it's somewhat similar to what I asked you previously. So it's like being the principal of PNC College, how do you strategize about the key programs and plans for the marketing and administration of your college? What are the plans that you have made in order to, you know, obviously the college might have developed a lot in the past few years. So obviously, what were the plans and what were the structures that you have taken, you have implemented for the college?
See, our focus has always been on qualitative teaching and learning aspects. So we have a team, like we have this academic governance structure. And, you know, so we have our academic heads and we have, you know, a planning done at the beginning of every semester about what are the activities to be done in the during the semester and all that. So that is regarding the academics. Similarly, we also prepare certain plan of action for, you know, how do we improve our visibility? How do we, you know, promote ourselves? Like, how do we, you know, make ourselves known to... you know, in the region or in the city and in the state and that's what we have another team which looks after those aspects also. But I didn't get your question. I hope I'm answering I didn't get it exactly.
So, yes, it was actually, I wanted to ask you that what are the plans and what you have done till date? Like, what are the strategies that you have taken into account in order to, you know, for the development of Pillimoti College of Architecture? That is what my question is. Because every college, it obviously grows every year, right? It builds up every year. So I just wanted to ask, my question was that how have you exactly planned and how you have been planning for the past few years in order to develop and bring Pillimoti what it was 28 years back and what exactly it is right now. So there will be a lot of difference in that, a lot of development, a lot of growth. So that was my question, that what are the plans that you have taken into account and how have you strategized all these plans?
Okay. So what we have actually been, we definitely take a look at the scenario, like, you know, every year, and we are bound by certain norms also. So we try to adhere to the norms, and we also look at the, you know, the demand and the necessities which are there in the education sector, and we try to strategize accordingly. So all our, you know, all the activities, academic activities are geared in that way. Okay, so we also look at like, you know, establishing, like when we find that, you know, that from the market, let us say, when we come to know that, okay, in certain areas maybe which requires improvement, then we try to build on those areas. Okay, like, you know, building on industry academia linkages, or like, you know, we always try, we take a feedback also from the companies or the offices where our students go for training. So then we try to find out what is the lacuna in the education also. If there is something that is missing, then we have to work on those areas, and we try to focus more on those areas. So when we do the academic planning at the beginning of every semester, we have all these data with us, the feedback from offices, the feedback from the market about, you know, what are the things which are necessary for, you know, developing the students. And so accordingly, we prioritize and we plan on the lectures or the methods of teaching that we adopt.
Okay, that is very great, and it's very crisp answer, ma'am. So that will do. So next question is, ma'am, since we have been introduced to this new NEP program, the National Education Policy has been implemented from this year itself. So since there's a lot of changes that has happened after NEP has been implemented, since the education system in India and other foreign countries are very structured, it is very structured differently. So let's say whatever we had in foreign countries and whatever we had in India, now it's somewhat similar because of the NEP program, right? So in your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your institute? I hope my question is clear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're talking in terms of like what are the changes or that we can bring about or what we are thinking in terms of the new education policy. See, we have even it's a very, very new thing, and there is a lot of deliberation going on now, even at the university level, and we are working together. So what has happened is they are trying to, you know, make the syllabus a little less structured than before. And, you know, so they are trying to make it open so students can opt for different electives, open electives, you know. So, and a student has the option of choosing, you know, certain courses and as per their interest. So those things, of course, like, you know, it is still at a nascent stage here. And we are in the, maybe in the next 3-4 months, things should be frozen. And I think it will offer a whole world of opportunity for the student who comes in, because it is actually going to give them the opportunity to explore their full potential. So we are also, as a college, we have certain electives which we offer, but there are some more things which are getting added. And, you know, so it's going to, because nowadays, like, you know, there's no discipline. Everything is very interdisciplinary. So finally, you find that architecture itself is, you know, transforming from one area, like, you know, being localized to one particular domain. Now you have the influence of several other domains coming in. So you have the influence of IT, you have the influence of artificial intelligence, virtual reality, augmented reality, all of them coming in. So all these options are going to, you know, throw up a whole world of opportunities for the students. That's what I feel. So though I will not say that it is concretized so far, it is still at a nascent stage. And we would be, it should be done within the next 3-4 months. Right.
Okay. So I'm moving towards the next question. How does the curriculum of PMCA College ensure the best practices industry?
Like I told you, see, the curriculum is, it is spread over 5 years and 10 semesters. And we have, like, you know, one semester which is dedicated for practical training, where students actually go and work with different architects and to gain a first-hand exposure about the practice. We also have, we have site visits, and we plan on these. We have construction yard also, where, you know, we expose them to, we simulate what is done actually on the field. So those kind of, you know, hands-on experience is always provided. And the other aspect, I would say, is, like, you know, this... we get in people from the industry who come and, you know, who educate students about the newer practices, and then also, like, give them certain, sometimes there are these demo sessions which are organized in the college. So basically we try, and even like in the curriculum, in all the subjects, in fact, we try to think of the horizontal linkages, vertical linkages that are possible. And wherever possible, we try to take them, you know, expose them to the developments and advances in the industry. So there are market surveys which are built into the curriculum. Then there are, like, you know, every time they work on a design project, which it is generally on a live site. So they are taken to the site and they get a first-hand experience of that. And then we have a lot of professionals also who come in and who share their experiences and values, and that is how we look at it. And we are, I would say, we are doing a fairly good job. And we, of course, you know, nothing ever stops. So we are always looking at improving our strategies.
Okay. So, ma'am, moving towards the next question, as I said that you will be sharing a lot of insights of Pillamoti College with all the viewers out there who are watching us. So the next question is about the insights only, that if you have any insights into how exactly your college could be more welcoming to the students of different races or maybe different economic backgrounds. So if you could just elaborate on the this particular statement.
Actually, I say, I always feel that, you know, this college, we always have this in our philosophy, vision, mission, whatever you call it, you know. It's like, you know, we have a very cosmopolitan attitude, and we have, we have students from various parts of the country actually studying here. We have people from the Northeast, we have people from West Bengal, we have people from Jharkhand, we even have people from Chennai and Delhi who come in here and who... So we are always very open to that. And if you talk about the economic background, there also like, you know, the education at Pillumodi is quite affordable actually. And one of the ways in which we ensure that, you know, there is no difference is like we have a set of, you know, there's a uniform that we follow. So everyone comes in the same kind of clothes. And so, you know, that brings about a kind of, I would say, equality. And, you know, it's like, you know, everybody is, we try and, you know, so it tries to reduce these gaps and differences and all that. So, you know, each one, so when they are in the college, they are part of the batch as a whole. And there is absolutely, you know, everybody is equal and everyone is treated in the same way. So I think this uniform, which is actually, it is not mandated by, it is mandated, though we follow it, it is mandated by the government of Orissa. And that is a good practice, I feel. Though, you know, sometimes we have had people coming in and saying, why do you have this system? But we feel that it works fine with us because we are able to, you know, establish that kind of equality among students. And we also try and, you know, we allow them, that allows them to focus more on their work and not less on the, you know, appearance or clothes kind of. And it also brings about, we feel, we have seen, I think they develop a natural bonding also because of that. So that I feel is a good practice. That's what we have been doing over so many years.
So the college uniform has actually helped all the students to be bonded with each other in the college.
Yes, they in fact start calling, you know, addressing each other by the, you know, the color of the uniform. Like they say that we are yellow batch or green batch, or, you know, so that's what we feel. So over a period of time, we have seen students addressing themselves as a batch of, and using the color. I think that unites them.
Okay. That is very nice. And this is something new that I've heard from any of the dignitaries of the college. So it's really nice. Yeah. So ma'am, moving towards the next question, ma'am, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the college and the students are? What, according to you, are your roles and responsibilities to the college and student?
I as the principal, I am the administrative head. So I have to ensure that there is discipline and, you know, that classes are conducted on time and these kind of, you know, and of course we have people who are helping me in the job. But basically what I try to enforce is this, that, you know, that there's a sense of discipline in the college, I would say. And I think I am, might be hated also because of, I have to be strict, but that's because of the role that I have. And though, like, you know, off campus or sometimes, you know, during off times, I'm friendly with students. It's, you know, though I'm not overtly, I mean, my position does not allow me to be overtly friendly. So, but then, of course, we have other teachers. We have proctors who, you know, interact with students and, you know, they are like friend, philosopher, guide. So I'm at the back, in the background, I'm always telling the proctors that you are actually a friend, philosopher and guide because I'm not permitted to do that. So that's how it is. So we have different levels of, you know, in the organization, different levels of this administration mechanism, which is there. And as the principal, of course, I feel my job is to ensure that, you know, teaching learning continues unhampered, unhindered, and in the best possible way. And through, you know, discipline, you know, a disciplined environment, I would say.
Okay, so moving ahead with the disciplinary committee that you are a member of, obviously you are in the college and you are looking after that disciplinary thing. So I just wanted to ask, ma'am, after that, what exactly is your plan in the past, in the next 10 years that you might be planning? Like, what do you think, according to you, is your priority right now, which will be, let's say that it's been 28 years now. So in the next 10 years or maybe in the next 28 years, it's a long time to ask, but yes, in the next 10 years, what are your plans and what are your priorities that you have set for the college, for the development of the college?
Okay.
See, in the near future, we hope, like we have been doing quite well, I feel, in the at the university level. We are a nodal center for research. We have been, we are members of, I mean, our faculty, myself, we are all members of the Board of Studies also in the university. So academically, I think we are doing quite fine as far as the university is concerned. But at the same time, at the state level, what I mean to say, at the national level, our plan is like, you know, we should get NAC accredited by this year. We are trying for that. And so that, you know, we are able to set a benchmark for ourselves. You know, so every day is a process of, you know, improvement and, you know, trying to work towards a larger goal. So in the short term, we have NAC as one of our prime objective, achieving that. And secondly, we also are looking at, you know, an NIRF ranking if possible. And that is also one of the targets, and maybe autonomy a little later.
Okay, so I have actually discussed this with Panda sir about the NIAC accreditation. So yeah. We have discussed, yes ma'am. Yeah. So, yes. So, the next question is, ma'am, that when you have come, I guess you might have joined in the initial days of Pilu Modi College, right? You are you?
Yeah, I was there. I joined in 97, actually, and then had to leave in between for about 4 years. I was not there. Then again, I rejoined back from 2002, 2001 end or 2002. Of course, I was at a junior level that time. I started off as an assistant professor only. Then
that is actually my, sorry to interrupt ma'am, but yes. That is actually my question, that when you first came to Pilu Modi College, what was your vision for this college and how has it evolved over the time and what is your experience and how are you implementing your vision into the, whatever the vision was of that college prior to you join? So that is my question now. Yes, I'm actually, you were explaining it that only, like how you joined in 97.
I was saying that, initially, of course, like when we joined, I was, we had our founder director, architect KB Mohapatra, he was in charge of affairs. And he always had this vision of, you know, improving the, you know, trying to make the college one of the best in the Eastern region. So that was always the vision. And we still continue in the same way. And today we are, we can proudly say that we are one of the good colleges in this part of the country, and we have been doing extremely well. Our alumni are placed in different, nationally, very good organizations, both nationally as well as in international bodies. And they are doing extremely well. And we are, today we can very proudly say that we have really come quite far from, you know, from the way we started. When we started, it was only with 22 students and the first batch on the college. And today we have a batch strength of 120. So we have been progressing quite well, I would say. And the vision has always been to excel in terms of teaching learning. So that has been the major focus always. And we have tried to stick to that, you know, so whatever is required for that, you know, we have always tried to do that.
Okay, so moving to the next question, ma'am, is there anything that you want the people out there to know about the college? Like a few things which are not, let's say, we do not get everything on internet, right? So I just wanted to ask you that if there are any such insights of the college which you want to share with the youth. So ma'am, please go ahead.
Okay. One thing is, okay, first thing is we believe in, you know, quality education, but which is also affordable. So that is one of our prime things. So it is, it's always the fee structure is quite reasonable. And so when, you know, it's quite comfortable for the parents, like when they send a child here. And second thing is we have a very, very friendly, you know, teacher-student relationship. Most of the students, most of the teachers are very student-friendly, and it's almost like a second home. So we pride ourselves in calling ourselves PMCA family. So whenever a student enters the campus, it's like from day one itself, we welcome them as, you know, welcome to the family. So everyone is a, you know, part of the college, and they can share whatever things, whatever opinions or feelings or any kind of problems that they have. Problems and issues are always, the teachers are very open to everything, and we are, they guide them also in a proper way. So I think that is one of our strongest points also, I would say, that because we believe in molding good individuals. So we are looking at building character. We try to build the character of the student also, while at the same time making him a skilled professional. And that is it, I would say. Main focus being, you know, truthfulness, integrity, and fellow feeling. These are the qualities that we try to develop in them. And that is also what we always, demonstrate through our actions and even with the management. The management is also extremely very open and very, forthcoming at every time. So every students also have access, you know, if with permission, of course, they can even meet the management, and in case of grievances and also, it's a very, very open and a transparent system. So that again, I think, is one of our plus points. So it is not that we have a lot of, it's not like a, what do you call it? I would say we are very open and very, What is the word? I'm just generally open to everybody's needs and problems and issues, and we try to resolve it amicably as far as possible.
Okay, ma'am. So in this era, like whatever has happened till date, I just wanted to ask you, the next question is quite internal. So if there are any challenges that you might have faced till date in terms of higher education, whatever we are offering in PMCA, or maybe like you can just let me know specifically about PMCA and about the higher education, that higher education as in general. So if you might have faced any challenges anywhere in your life, in your career, in your professional career with PMCA?
Higher education, I didn't get it. Like we offer a course, we offer a postgraduate program also in the college. Is that what you are saying?
And no,
there's not. Okay.
Yeah. So basically the question is that what are the challenges, like the biggest challenges you see both for higher education in general and in PMCA specifically? That is what my question is. We can start with the challenges that you might have faced in PMCA in your whole journey, like any one, two challenges that you might have faced.
I don't see many challenges as such, but yes, architecture as a discipline is still not, for the common man, I think there is still a lot of awareness that needs to be created, maybe, because there's people generally, look at it and as if it's another engineering discipline, which it is not. So that is one of the challenges I see. So we need to, go to the grassroots and, make people aware about this course and about this program. Though like in urban areas, it's not a problem, but especially in rural areas of the state, in Orissa and in, your class 3, class 4 kind of towns, the awareness for the course is not there. And so that is the challenge. But then I think we are working on it. There are certain, it is improving now with a lot of, with this, the Ministry of Urban Development and Housing and these people, taking proactive steps now. I think people are understanding now about the role and importance of architecture. Especially, I'm only talking about Orissa. In Orissa, this is the thing. But in other states, I think it is much more developed and much better. But in Orissa, that is a challenge, that especially in the smaller towns, we have, there is a lack of awareness, and people think of it as just as another engineering program. And another disadvantage with architecture versus engineering is that this is a 5-year program. and the other courses are like 4 years. So people normally think of it, why should we do 5 years and not four? But again, so that is a challenge that needs to be overcome. So of course, people who are really keen and really interested in the course, they always find their way. But for the common person, they need to be, made more aware about the scope of this profession.
Okay, so ma'am, moving towards the last question, I just want to ask you that if you have any suggestions that you want to give to the current youth and aspiring students, and maybe the students who will be joining, who are planning to join Pulumoti College of Architecture for their higher education. So any suggestions that you want to highlight on?
Suggestions. Okay, I would say that this is a extremely rewarding career option for, students who would be, who are thinking or who have still not decided about it, because it is a creative field and, sky is the limit. If you're good at your work, then sky is the limit for them. And there is no end to creativity. They can always, keep on honing their skills as they grow in the profession. And this profession offers extreme creative satisfaction because of the nature of the profession, because the joy of, creating something is there, and you can actually see something that you have conceived. You can actually, whatever you might have visualized, you can actually get it built, so that, the happiness or the joy of, seeing something that you have thought about or you have dreamt about and that coming true, that there is a whole lot of, excitement in that. So this career offers a lot of excitement, a lot of imagination, a lot of creative freedom. And I would say that, but of course, there is one thing that you have to be hardworking. That is one of the basic things that people there's no substitution for hard work. So hard work and sincerity have to go along. So they are, that is the mantra actually to succeed. But once you are there, or if you are in the profession, then I don't think there should be any regrets, because it is a very, very enjoyable and wonderful line to be in.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for connecting with us. We are very glad that you could spare some time after a long break. And thanks a lot. And I guess that whatever insights you have given, you have provided in your this complete discussion, this will definitely help the students in order to, to clarify all their doubts and everything, and they can just join the college and relive the surrounding, the environment that you have over there. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ayushi.